Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we're going to be talking about how to make and paint and make them look interesting the snake fences that come in the Warlord Games American Civil War box set. So they come on these quite interesting sheets and you've got to break them out. You get two different sizes, you get some which are two planks and some which are three. You do need to be slightly careful with them just because they can potentially, if you put a bit too much pressure on, you'll snap them. So just be careful when you're getting them out. Some of the planks do have sort of a divider in between which you will have to push through, but overall it's not hard at all. You can push them all out and clean them up with a little bit of sandpaper, or in this case I was just using my clippers just to take the edges off. Very quick, very easy to do. In the main box, I can't remember exactly, but I think you get two of the packs or two of the sheets of fencing. Yeah, I'm sure it was two sheets, so plenty of fencing to go around. Then once you got them, you could theoretically just paint them up flat as individuals, and then you can put your fences together however you want them. I found, in my opinion, making them into sort of L shapes worked best for me, or Z's, just because that way it gives you the flexibility to be able to build them up into larger fences, but also for transportation purposes, just having slightly smaller ones was an easier option. So once I'd got them all how I wanted them, I used PVA, well, Mod Podge in this case, but you could use PVA, you could use wood glue, just dabbed it in over the joint, and then you just push them together and then let the glue dry. So very quick, very easy. You could probably use super glue or most other types of glue. This is just what I had to hand, so it's nice and easy. Then again, like I've shown in some of my other videos, I just had a dark brown which I brought from a local the warehouse. I think it cost a couple of dollars, and I used that just to base coat them. And then once I've finished base coating, obviously you've got to leave them to dry, but then it's time to start highlighting. I do the highlights with dry brush. Again, I was going for speed. They're not art pieces, they are literally just the scenery, so I want them to look reasonably good on the table without wasting too much time on. So I used the same dark brown as the base coat, and then I added a little bit of white and a little bit of bone colour, which I had mixed those together, and then that's what I used just to do my highlighting or dry brushing. Then I went over them a second time just with a little bit more of a lighter one, just to really pick out the edges. Then it was time to just add the finishing touches. You don't have to, at this stage, do what I'm about to. They would be fine as is, but I decided I just wanted to break them up a little bit more, so I got a little bit of clump foliage. A friend did give me some trees a few weeks ago, so I've got a couple of the smaller ones, which I'm just starting to add into a few of my different scenery pieces, just to give a little bit of height in some places. So again, I started off just using a little bit of a splodge of Mod Podge again, put it into a few different locations, usually in the corners, just because that's where you're tending to find plants growing in the wild, just because it's a little bit more sheltered than right in the center. And then you grab your flocking or clump foliage or the little tree and stick it in. Then you just need to leave it then until it dries out. So very quick, very easy. Now, I wouldn't say to do this on all of your fencing. I already have quite a few pieces which are plain, so maybe do one in three of them with a little bit of foliage on, maybe every other one, and then make your third one have a tree or something just to make it stand out a little bit more. Ultimately, it's up to you. But overall, I found it to be a nice, fun project. Makes the fences stand out a little bit more. They're not just all the same. And so I really enjoyed it. and I think they look pretty cool on the table. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and I look forward to you coming back and seeing the next video where we've got a different type of hedge and fence combo. See you then.